the goal of my mind, the aim of my life, the goal of a Christian living. I want to do what pleasing to my God. Let anything happen. Let it be any cost. I'm here for my God. Why? Why God can die and tell me that I am for you? Why can't I tell I am for you, Lord? When I respond to him, I am for you, Lord. Why should he ask me, do you love me? I say, yes, I am loving you. All my life is for you. When that becomes not saying, my life becomes a response. It is there. The Holy Spirit is abiding. It is there. We are born again. It is not simply you drown with the water. Either you yesterday you are received the child baptism. So now you go into the relief. Next moment you are falling in sin. It is not the type of baptism you receive. The baptism is you have to be born again in the Spirit. Born again with the presence of God. Born again with the truth of God. It is not your the way of. So all those who are drowned in the baptism, they are all going to heaven? No. It is not how you are received baptism. How are you living with the presence of God? Is the light shines in you that the darkness may not overtake you? Check. It is there you are born again. Hallelujah. So the fear that is brought by the enemy has to be overcome, the fear of God. That I am the child of God. I have come from God. That is the first fear of God means, first stage of fear of God means, all that I have comes from my God. My talents, my height, my family background, everything is gift of God. Second, everything I am given is for a purpose of God. Not I can use my talent as I wish. I can use my beauty, or I can use my money, I can use my certificates. No. There is a purpose. If you move out of God's set, walk in the light which I have given to you, walk in the clouds inside you. The moment they went out, the snakes that were waiting bit them. For the Israelites, on a particular day, 23,000 people died. If you are not living in the light, darkness will overtake you. Yes, that's what. When you walk in the fear of God, all I have has a purpose of God. Not I as I wish I can do with my life, with my talents. No, I have to check. Third, one day I have to stand before him and answer him. What did I do with my life? What did I do with what God gave to me? There are many people throw away their life and talents to earn money, to become famous. And at the end of the day, what? What more than that? Nothing. What more than that? Blessed are those who have received opportunity to walk in the Spirit. Galatians chapter 3 says, how is it that you offered your life for the Spirit and you ended up with the flesh? You ended up with the world? You learned. I know about a lady in Pune. When I was studying music, she was a very famous dancer. She learned, being a South Indian, a Keralite, she learned Bharatanatyam. And she became famous. She was called to Kerala. She was called all over. And then, she at the end, for the sake of, she moved away from God. She forgot what God gave her. Suddenly one man, when she went to Gulf, one man said, I will give you 10,000 dinari. Each dinari cost how much? Now 300 rupees? She was so much attracted. For what? Spend a week with me. That's all. She thought for a while, if I get this much money, I can be happy. I can have everything. The talent that God gave her to glorify God. There was a program. She is supposed to prepare an album. She threw away that album from Bombay. Someone gave her the album to do, a Christian album. She threw it away and went to Gulf. She earned the money, spent a week with that old man. Yes. Who earned the money with his oil in a dirty money. And she earned the money, came back. Suddenly she realized her whole body is full of pain. That fellow threw millions of rupees because some foolish fellow said, if you live with a virgin and all your HIV AIDS will go away. Today she is in the bedridden. She is dying. You began your work, your talents, Father Spirit, and you ended with flesh and the world. She's dying. Will that Arab come to help her? Arab will say, I myself is dying with this sickness. What can I do for you? I gave you enough money. Don't come to me. Will the parents stand with her? What talent God gave you? Why did you go? As long as you earn money, they will say, good, good, good. The moment you become helpless, you have taken the decision, not we. Have the fear of God. One day, whatever you do with your life, with your talents, with your beauty, with your education, with your money, one day you have to answer to Him. What have you done with what I trusted and gave you for the glory to live in the light? All that you have received from God has to be lived in the light. Otherwise, the darkness will overtake you. And that's what we find. With the fear of God, Joseph overcame the fear of the world. The lady said, I will throw you into the jail. She is the woman with authority. He knows. But the worldly authority cannot do anything when I am conscious and live with the authority of God. When he had the fear of God, let anything happen, I will not allow my soul to be defiled. Let any cost. When he stood with that, which is the fear of God, he could overcome. He could not allow the evil to, the darkness to overtake him. Shall we pray? The word of God says, I have not given you the spirit of timidity, the fear, the worries. Now Elijah, when he lost the presence of God and allowed the darkness to peep into his life slowly, slowly, slowly. Now the great servant of God is lying at the feet of the enemies, place of snakes and scorpions. In the place of enemy, he talks the language of the enemy. I want to die. I want to die. But the love and call of God is irrevocable. The mercy of God sends the angel to feed him. Even in the desert, even in the drought, your God is all powerful. While the whole nation is dying of hunger, God will feed you, his children who trust in him. Psalm 34 verse 10. The lion's cubs may be hungry, but those who trust in the Lord, they will be never hungry. சிங்க குட்டிகள் பட்டினியால் தவிக்கும், ஆனால் தேவனை தேடுவோருக்கு ஒரு குறையும் வராது. God will take care of his children. Yes. God has not called us to be live in fear, but in the love. I have a Father who cares for me. I have a Father who loves me. My God is all powerful. Every minute I need to feed. The enemy has entered into you. Enemy has come in the form of black magic. The enemy has come in the form of various fear, worries, anger. Now you feed yourself with these three truths. The more you feed, the enemy will get out of your mind. He will get out of your body. He will get out of your life. Feed yourself. Your God is a loving Father. Your God is all-knowing. Nothing can happen to Him without His knowledge. Not a hair of yours will fall without His knowledge. Your God is all-knowing and He is all-powerful. He is full of wisdom and knowledge. He is sufficient for you. Delight in Him. Delight in Him. Be satisfied in Him. Enjoy Him. Celebrate Him. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. The love I have today, my Lord, is only a shadow of your love for me. Your deep abiding love, Lord, the joy you have for me is incomparable with the joy I have for you. The joy you have in me, seeing me, you are so happy, seeing me as your child. The plans you have for me is so great in front of the plans I have for you and I have for myself. The dreams I have today, my Lord, is only a shadow of your dreams for me. Your light in me will shine. My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. My love for you will grow, my Lord. Your light in me will shine. Your light in me will shine. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.